All right, listen, this guy doesn't need any introduction. He is the QB1 of the Chicago Bears, Justin Fields. I'm joined by now with his dad, Pablo. And we are out in Northbrook at Duncan because it's a cop on a rooftop where we raise some money for the Special Olympics. Thank you guys for being with us this morning.
Yeah, no problem. Appreciate you for having us.
Good to meet you too, sir. Thank you for all you've done in your line as well. Former police officer yourself. That's why you're here. What's it like growing up with a dad for a cop?
You know, pretty strict at times, but, you know, I wouldn't want it any other way now. Of course, when I was younger, didn't like all the punishments I used to get for not doing the right thing or not getting the right grades. But, you know, he's, you know, helped me become the man I am today. So it's been awesome having him. You know, he's told me a bunch of cop stories. So it's definitely been great for sure.
I grew up with a very strict dad myself. And even now at my age, he's still breaking my chops all the time. You loosening up on this kid or what?
I'm trying. It's hard. But I'm trying to loosen up a little bit. So
He has for sure.
You got to be so proud of this guy, huh?
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Super proud of him. You know, he got into all of his trouble in the house, never out of the house. So I always appreciated him for that, you know.
How are you feeling? I mean, you had your offseason going. You got the OTAs coming up. I mean, I know you've been working out with guys, but it's different when you're in the building and it's supervised. It's kind of that first chance to make that first impression of what you've been doing in the offseason. How excited are you to get back with the guys full time?
Very excited. You know, we've been working together for a few weeks now. So, you know, I know all the guys are excited. The coaches are too. So we've just been trying to, you know, build that chemistry throughout, you know, everyone in the building and, you know, getting to know each other on a personal level. So just hanging out outside of the facility and, you know, just really building that chemistry, that team chemistry, and that connection. So it's going to be a fun year. Sure.
How does it work out? Because I know you guys all work out in the offseason. Like, are you on like a text thread? Like, hey guys, meet me at the park, and you know, couple hours. Like, how does that? What are the logistics of that?
Yeah. So I mean, some guys work out in the same cities, but most of us don't. You know, some guys have, you know, offseason homes where they might go and stay. So you know, I was working out with a couple of guys down in Florida this past offseason. So if we are in the same city, then we will work out together. But probably sometime. And this next little break we get, we'll probably all go somewhere and, you know, train together for a little bit. So
let me ask you about I mean, I know the Bears in the offseason a lot was providing you with some weapons, protection. You got to be thrilled with that he's got a little protection this year and guys to throw. So I want to talk to you about DJ Moore. This is a guy, like, who's put up great numbers with a lot of different quarterbacks. To me, he seems like a guy that you put him in this situation with a Pro Bowl caliber quarterback. Like, the sky is the limit for this guy. But when I hear, like, these pundits talk about him, nobody really lists him as a guy that's an A-list guy. What are your impressions of him and how good he can be in this system?
I mean, yeah, he's a baller. From the first time I threw to him, you can kind of just tell when that guy has, you know, that it factor. And you can kind of tell when his hands are natural, his routes are, you know, he's a really great route runner and stuff like that. And, you know, he's a great athlete on the field, but even better person off the field. So got to hang out with him and his family when he first moved up here, first visited Chicago. So it was awesome for that. You know, went to the Bulls game with him, got to get to know him a little bit more. And I mean, I think he's, you know, been meshing well with everybody on the team. Everybody loves him. Hard worker, like I said before, and, you know, he's a great addition to our team.
How's it work for you? I mean, the draft was a pretty solid draft for the Bears. Are they in contact with you before, going into it, during? How does that process work? Because obviously, you know, they obviously want to know what you think of some of these guys too.
Yeah, you know, just sat down with Ryan Poles, I think, a day or two before the draft. And, you know, he kind of, you know, talked to me about what was going on through his head, what he kind of thought would happen during the draft. So, yeah, just communicating with that and, you know, telling me his thoughts. Because you never know how the draft's going to go down. So. Really just prepare for every situation and then, you know, just kind of told me his thoughts about it. And, you know, I think we had a pretty good draft. So a lot of great guys and a lot of great rookies came in, you know, ready to work. So it's going to be awesome. Going to be awesome for sure.
Do you have a sense of how much Bears fans love you? Like, I mean, you know, I've been here a long time and they've gotten excited about some quarterbacks, but I don't think they've gotten as excited about any quarterbacks as they do with you. Even when you have an off game, they'll be on Twitter. But did you see this one play? This guy's incredible. Like this crowd will be triple by the end of this interview. Are you aware of that? What does that mean to you?
I am. You know, ever since I stepped foot in the city, ever since I got drafted, I felt the love from the fans, the city, and, you know, everywhere we go, you know, we see it as a team. As a organization, how, you know, much love we get from the city, of Chicago Bears fans. So it's, you know, awesome to have such great fans. Awesome to have a great city behind you. And no matter what our record was last year, you know, they always showed up and supported. So, you know, just very thankful for those Bears fans for sure.
All right. Yeah, we are here at Cop on a Rooftop. If you visit any Dunkin' in the Chicagoland area in the state, you can donate. You can also donate online. Hopefully the rain will let up and we'll get a cop on the roof. How about you? You want to get up on the roof, Officer Fields?
Oh, yeah. I've been on one before, so I can do it again.
You know. What do you do up there the whole time? You just hang out and gossip?
Eat donuts. You know, eat donuts on the side. You can't let everybody see you eat a donut, you know, get those little jokes. So.
You want to bring him up there with you? You think the Bears would be okay with their quarterback on a slippery roof?
Yeah, he'd be all right. He'd be all right. He can hold his own. I think he can hold his balance up there.
All right. Well, Justin, good luck to you this year. We're all excited about the steps you're going to take and this team is going to take. And thank you, Officer Fields, for all you've done and for being a part of this today. All right. We'll send things back to you guys. It's Justin Fields.